we saw an opportunity to deliver a new console that was a new level performance in the market. We talked to our development partners. They saw a great opportunity to bring their games to life in a way that they haven't been able to do on console before. So we saw that combination of things happen, and the Xbox One X was kind of born from that. And the results we're seeing are pretty fantastic.
Is this a reset button for the Xbox One? Because arguably before, there's concerns with the Xbox One launch that it was trying to do too much. It wasn't just for gamers. Is this kind of like the Xbox One coming back to gaming?
Yeah, you know, I think we've had the focus on our family of devices and making sure that people who bought the original Xbox One, the millions of people who purchased Xbox One S, came out last year, great console, and Xbox One S X, that it's a continual family where all the games work across all the devices, all your accessories work across all the devices. So it's not really a reset in the fact that it's connected to the rest of the family of devices. And if you look at it, you know, price is really critical to people buying a console. So we're giving consumers choice. For somebody who's very value conscious, likes the performance of an Xbox One S, says that's the right price for me, that console's there for them, and I think that console's gonna do very well this year for us. The X is for the more discerning kind of gamer who looks at, wants the very best in performance, the very best in what they can get on their television set, and that's why we built that console.
So you have all of this great state-of-the-art facilities here to work on the new Xbox One X. Maybe talk a little bit about what that means, having it right here on the campus.
Yeah, we have an advanced prototyping lab here on campus. And having been someone who's worked on the console since the original Xbox, it's a dramatic shift in how we used to develop consoles. One of the things that's great about having all of the equipment here is it really allows us to more rapidly prototype and iterate ideas. So not only can the team sort of brainstorm and actually see those ideas come to life quicker, but I think it also allows us to have our designs be more inclusive for people with different hand sizes and people who have different abilities. Before, it would take weeks, perhaps, to try and generate these ideas and come back and test them. Now, within a much shorter period of time, we can go and test. We can see ideas in practical terms, and it just allows us to be so much more inclusive in how we think about developing products than we were able to be in the past.
Do you think gamers are ready for this shift, this kind of cell phone-like iterative change?
I hope so. The enthusiasm that we've seen from our fans gives me a lot of hope. But I think it's important to say, unlike a console generation, we're not asking people to switch. We're not asking people to abandon what they've already bought. If you bought an Xbox One when we launched, it's a great product. We're gonna continue to support it. All the games are gonna work. But there is a customer out there who wants the most performant thing they can buy, that always wants to be on the bleeding edge. And so we think there's a customer who's gonna like this product. But the most important thing is, you can't go wrong buying an Xbox One, whether you buy an Xbox One S or an Xbox One X.
Is there concern over brand confusion amongst consumers who aren't as familiar when they go to the store and they see multiple Xbox Ones, and the last thing you want is, you know, grandma making the wrong decision for their grandchild? Is there worry about confusion?
Well, fundamentally there will be two. Okay. And the price difference between the two is enough. I think you're gonna have somebody that walks in and they're gonna say, hey, am I in the market for a console that's at this price, or am I in the market for a console that's at price? They're gonna look at what's on screen, they're gonna put controller in their hands, they're gonna get to feel it, what it feels like, what it looks like to play those games, and they're gonna make the decision based on what's important to them. Mm-hmm. And I think that's the most we can do as a consumer product company, is deliver consumers choice, let them decide how important is gaming to them, and what they see on screen is through their own eyes, what they feel in the controller in their hands, through their hands. And they should make the choice between the two consoles.